Investigators are trying to determine how a loaded prop gun made it into the hands of actor Alec Baldwin on a movie set in New Mexico last week. The gun went off, killing the film's cinematographer and wounding the director. The Santa Fe County Sheriff's Office will hold a news conference on Wednesday, and we're learning more about the man responsible for safety on that set. New allegations that he missed basic safety protocols in the past. NBC News correspondent Aaron McLaughlin reports.
And I know we're all united right now, and I'm sorry.
In New Mexico, grief and countless unanswered questions after Alec Baldwin fired a gun on set that killed cinematographer Helena Hutchins.
You take a job to support your life. You shouldn't be giving your life to support the job.
This is new details have emerged about the film's assistant director, Dave Halls, the crew member responsible for safety on set and the man who handed Baldwin the loaded gun, declaring it safe moments before 42-year-old Hutchins was shot dead. Court records say Halls did not know live rounds were in the prop gun.
He said someone was shot. Two people accidentally.
Licensed pyrotechnician Margaret Gall worked with Halls on a previous project. She claims he failed to maintain a safe environment.
Not having safe exits, not having safe fire lanes, very, very, very basic safety issues.
Gall says she raised her concerns about Halls to the producers at Blumhouse Television, but nothing happened. A Blumhouse spokesperson tells NBC News that no complaints were received via the studio's anonymous system regarding safety concerns. A source close to the production says a 2019 complaint had been lodged against Halls and his lack of respect for personal space, noting following the complaint, he was never hired by the studio again. Halls declined to comment when reached by NBC News.
This is probably the most egregious negligent accident I've heard of in film history.
Clay Vansickle has been a Hollywood armorer for 18 years. He shows us it's easy to make sure a gun is safe.
Step one is rotating through all six cylinders so you can clearly see that they're empty. I would click through the gun six times, and sometimes seven just to be sure, so everybody knows that this is a completely inert weapon.
In Hollywood, faced with senseless tragedy, growing calls for change.
This could very well end my career, but we have to speak up.
All right, we have more details from the sheriff's interview with Rust film director Joel Souza. According to new information released last night in search warrants, the cast and crew had taken a lunch break. And when they returned to rehearsal, Souza told authorities he wasn't sure if the firearm to be used by Baldwin had been checked anew for safety. Joel advised they returned back to the set after lunch, although he is not sure if the firearm was checked again, the warrant states. Joel stated they had Alec sitting in a pew in a church building setting, and he was practicing a cross draw. Joel said he was looking over the shoulder of Helena Hutchins when he heard what sounded like a whip and then a loud pop. The director said he vaguely remembers Hutchins' reactions. She was complaining about her stomach and grabbing her midsection, according to the warrant. Joel said that Helena began stumbling backwards and she was assisted to the ground, it said. Joel explained he was bleeding from his shoulder and he could see blood on Helena. Camera operator Reed Russell told authorities none of this was captured on camera because the cast and crew were preparing for the scene. He also said he was unsure if the gun had been checked because he had left the area for 5 minutes for a break. Reed said Alec had been very careful and brought up an instant when a scene was being filmed earlier, the warrant states. Reed said Alec had made sure it was safe and that a child wasn't near him when they were discharging a firearm during that scene. In a few minutes, we'll dig into the legal fallout and what charges could be in store for those responsible. In our 8 a.m. hour, we'll speak with a veteran stunt and special effects coordinator on how this accident could have possibly occurred. But Joe, there are a lot of issues and questions of liability here. Alec Baldwin, a producer on this movie, Gun safety experts will tell you and have been discussing this since this happened about some of the safety checks that happen on other movie sets, including opening a gun and showing it to the actor before it is used, and also just the basic gun safety 101, a gun loaded or unloaded,
right,
fake or real, prop or, you know, real gun is not ever pointed at another human being.
Well, and that's what I don't understand. There are a lot of things I don't understand here, and I know you've been reading up on this, getting ready for the show. But just basic gun safety. Basic gun safety. Let's start with the first thing that I think everybody's been hearing. But if you've ever been around a gun for more than 2 minutes, or 2 seconds, the first thing you do when you pick up that gun is you make sure that it's never pointed at anybody. And,
yeah,
and you see it time and again where somebody who's not been around guns their entire life will pick up a gun and immediately somebody else will just slowly move their arm away. You can never point at anybody, point it down. But that goes without saying. It's not even the first rule of holding a gun, using a gun. That'd be like saying that stepping into a car to drive a car was the first rule of driving a car. No, it's just assumed you never point a gun at anybody anywhere because you always assume that it's loaded. And,
right,
and then the next thing you do is when you pick up the gun and you always assume it's loaded, anybody that's ever been around a gun, the first thing they do is they always check. They always check to make sure that there's not a bullet in the chamber. Always.
Well,
doesn't matter what type of gun it is, they always check that, and it's obsessive. So the idea that on this set somebody would pick up a gun, aim it, and I don't know if it went off accidentally, but is there a different rule on Hollywood sets? Do they aim guns at people?
Because it seems bizarre. Joe, there are different, you know, levels of budget and exactly what was going on with the union and some complaints that day. But you pointed on two questions, and here's the other side, potentially, of the story with so many question marks at the end of everything we say. First of all, we've worked on sets. Was it dark? Did he not know he was pointing at someone? Did he actually pull the trigger, or was it just very, very sensitive and it accidentally, you know, he touched it and it fired. There are
right,
so many questions, but the basic thing that a lot of people are pointing to as they research this and talk to experts, the missing link may have been that check before the use of the weapon. Did it happen? And I can't find anywhere whether, you know, confirmation that
right,
check right before the rehearsal of the scene happened. And then you have to look at all the other factors and exactly what it looked like in a dark church when this scene was being rehearsed. It's a horrible, horrible, horrible situation all around.
A horrible situation, a horrible accident. Again, though, we'll be talking to a gun safety expert about what happens on Hollywood sets. But I find it hard to believe that the rules there aren't the rules everywhere else, which is you never point a gun at anyone. Never, ever. You don't do it unless you expect to shoot and cause injury to somebody. And again, every time you're holding a gun in your hand, when you first get it, you always assume it's loaded. And then it depends if, you know, you slide and you check and see actually if there's a round in the chamber. Always. I mean, again, that is so, that's so elemental. I just don't understand what was going on that set. There were so many things went wrong. Hey, thanks so much for watching our YouTube channel. You can follow up on today's top stories and breaking news or catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.